السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين، حبيب إله العالمين أبي القاسم المصطفى محمد. وعلى أهل بيته الطيبين الطاهرين. قال الله تعالى في كتابه الكريم: بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، ونريد أن نمن على الذين استضعفوا في الأرض ونجعلهم أئمة ونجعلهم الوارثين، ونمكن لهم في الأرض ونري فرعون وهامان وجنودهما منهم ما كانوا يحذرون. صلوا على محمد وآل محمد. Respected brothers and sisters, I begin by congratulating you all on one of the most important events in the history of this universe, and that is the birth of the final messenger, the final caliph of the final messenger, and the one who is the answered prayers of 124,000 prophets. And that is the promised savior, the one who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promised, not only in the Quran, but in the books prior to the Quran. Allah says in the Quran, وَلَقَدْ كَتَبْنَا فِي الزَّبُورِ مِنْ بَعْدِ الذِّكْرِ أَنَّ الْأَرْضَ يَرِثُهَا عِبَادِيَ الصَّالِحُونَ. It is written, it is decreed in the Psalms of David and in the books, the holy scriptures and literature before the Quran, that the earth shall be inherited by the righteous. In another verse, Allah says, هُوَ الَّذِي أَرْسَلَ رَسُولَهُ بِالْهُدَى وَدِينِ الْحَقِّ لِيُظْهِرَهُ عَلَى الدِّينِ كُلِّهِ. Allah says, He is the one who sent His prophet with huda, with guidance, and with the true religion, so that the true religion shall overcome everything. It shall encompass everything. Now we ask ourselves, is the religion of Islam, has the religion of Islam overcome everything? Has the religion of Islam prevailed today? The answer is no. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi, when he passed away, only Arabia and parts, small areas around Arabia had accepted the religion of Islam. And even today, the whole world has not accepted the religion of Islam. But this is a promise by Allah in the Quran. هُوَ الَّذِي أَرْسَلَ رَسُولَهُ بِالْهُدَى وَدِينِ الْحَقِّ لِيُظْهِرَهُ عَلَى الدِّينِ كُلِّهِ. So we see that never in the history of mankind has Islam and the truth and justice prevailed over everything else. That means the promise of Allah has not taken place yet. That means we are still waiting for that time. We are still waiting for that promise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And it will only take place through a man who is from the progeny of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi, from the family of Rasulullah, and this is through Imam al-Mahdi ajjalallah ta'ala farajahu sharif. Now, the birth, the belief in Imam al-Mahdi, a lot of people think that this is just something that the Shias believe in. It's only a belief that a small group of Muslims believe in. But that's not true. The belief in a savior at the end of time is a belief that not only all Muslims believe in, but also other religions believe in a savior at the end of time. And all Muslims agree that one of the children from the descendants of the Prophet, he will rise at the end of time and he will unite everyone with justice. In a hadith from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi, he says, كَيْفَ أَنْتُمْ إِذَا ظَهَرَ ابْنُ مَرْيَمْ وَإِمَامُكُمْ مِنْكُمْ. How would you feel, how would you be when the son of Mary rises, meaning Isa, he comes back, وَإِمَامُكُمْ مِنْكُمْ, and the imam, the one who will be leading the prayer, is from you, the Muslims, referring to Imam al-Mahdi, ajalallah ta'ala farajahu al-sharif. Now, what is the goal? What is the purpose of the imam? What will he do when he appears? The answer, we recite it in many of the du'as, in many of the ziyaras of the imam. In one du'a, which we will be reciting in just a couple of days, in the month of Ramadan, in du'a al-iftitah, one segment of that du'a, we say, وَأَظْهِرْ بِهِ دِينَكَ. The religion, it will become very apparent. Reality, truth from falsehood will be very clear. Today, many people are confused. What is Islam? They don't know whether to accept Islam, that what they see on the media, or they don't know. A lot of people are confused what the religion of Islam is. أَظْهِرْ بِهِ دِينَكَ. Through him, religion is going to be very apparent. وَسُنَّةَ نَبِيِّكَ, and the true sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi, حَتَّى لَا يَسْتَخْفِيَ بِشَيْءٍ مِّنَ الْحَقِّ مَخَافَةَ أَحَدٍ مِّنَ الْخَلْقِ. So that truth shall never be compromised. Truth and justice will never be compromised when the imam reappears and the imam rises. So the imam alayhi salam, his task will be to spread the religion of Islam. Spread it the way his grandfather spread the religion of Islam. Today, there are many that give the impression that the imam, the first thing that he will do when he rises is he will take a sword and he will begin to kill people here and there. This is not true. This is not the way the imam is. Why? Because this is not the way his grandfather was. This is not the way Rasulullah was. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes Rasulullah in the Quran with which verse? With which word? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he speaks about Rasulullah, Allah speaks about the rahmah, the mercy of Rasulullah, the love. وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ. We sent you as a mercy, only as a mercy to mankind. So if Rasulullah was sent as a mercy to mankind, his grandson, Imam al-Hujjah, is also a mercy to mankind. And this is why people will enter the religion of Islam. يَدْخُلُونَ فِي دِينِ اللَّهِ أَفْوَاجًا. People will come and they will be yearning for that message that the imam brings. Why? Because of a very long occultation. And there's a philosophy behind this occultation. Many people ask, why do we have to wait for such a long time? Isn't there enough injustice in the world? Isn't there enough oppression in the world going on today? Why do we have to wait for such a long time? The answer, of course, the answer is with Allah. But one answer is so that people experience every single type of government. So that people experience every single type of financial system, every single type of government, and then they will see that those governments are not perfect. Those governments that came out in the name of equality and justice and giving rights to people, they're not perfect. Then when the imam comes, people will be begging to follow the imam. And people will be rushing towards the imam and anticipating the arrival of the imam. Imam al-Hujjah, ajjalallah ta'ala farajahu al-sharif, He is the one who will fulfill the task and the job and the role of 124,000 prophets and messengers. It is going to be through him that they will all achieve their goals. And this is why we are not surprised when we see that through his life, there's a resemblance with many of the prophets of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In the life, in the birth, in the occultation, in the ghaibah of Imam al-Hujjah, there's a lot of resemblance between the Imam and many of the prophets of Allah. Why? It makes sense because he is the one who is going to finish their job, the job that they started. In a hadith from Imam al-Sadiq alayhi salam, he says, إِنَّ اللَّهَ تَبَارَكَ وَتَعَالَى أَدَارَ فِي الْقَائِمْ مِنَّا ثَلَاثَةً أَدَارَهَا فِي ثَلَاثَةٍ مِنَ الرُّسُلِ Imam Sadiq says, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose for our qa'im, the imam who will rise at the end of time, three features which he chose for three of the messengers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then the imam says, قَدَّرَ مَوْلِدَهُ تَقْدِيرُ مَوْلِدْ مُوسَى عَلَيْهِ السَّلَامُ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decreed that the birth of Imam al-Hujjah is a hidden birth. Not only when he is born, he is hidden, but even through his birth and the pregnancy of his mother, it was a hidden birth. And this is exactly like the birth of Prophet Musa alayhi salam. Pharaoh, he had an army that would go to the houses of the Israelites and they would check who is pregnant. Whoever was pregnant, they would right away kill her child. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in order to preserve and protect the life of Prophet Musa, the pregnancy of his mother was hidden. They sent people to go and check her. They saw that there are no signs of pregnancy. So this is the same with Imam Al-Hujjah Ajjalallahu Ta'ala Farajahu Sharif. There were no signs of the pregnancy until hours and moments before the birth of the Imam. Second, the Imam says, وَقَدَّرَ غَيْبَتَهُ تَقْدِيرُ غَيْبَةِ عِيسَى عَلَيْهِ السَّلَامُ And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decreed that the Imam is in a state of occultation, in a state of ghaibah. Now today, many people, some Muslims, non-Muslims, they're surprised. How can an Imam be in ghaibah? Well, let me ask you a question. Isn't Isa, Jesus, in ghaibah right now? Jesus is in a state of occultation right now. Isa, we believe that he did not die, we as Muslims. He was not killed. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took him away to preserve his life. And at the end of time, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bring him back. And this is the same with the Imam alayhi salam, who is also in a state of ghaibah. And then the Imam says, وَقَدَّرَ إِبْطَاؤُهُ تَقْدِيرُ إِبْطَاءُ نُوحِ عَلَيْهِ السَّلَامُ And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala destined that the Imam has a long life. Who out of the prophets of Allah has a very long life? We all know this. But then when it comes to the Imam, many of us act surprised. Many of us find it very difficult to believe. Prophet Nuh alayhi salam, he lived over 1,000 years. Prophet Nuh, he lived for a very long time. So why is it difficult for me to comprehend that the Savior and the Imam and the final Imam, and the one who is a promised savior by Allah, he also lived a long time. Why is it difficult to believe? If you believe in the Quran, if you accept the Quran as a Muslim, then it will be very easy to accept the Imam. Because if you accept that the prophets used to speak at birth, Prophet Isa and others, or they were prophets when they were younger, then where is it difficult? Why is it difficult to accept that the Imam alayhi salam also has a miraculous element in his birth, in his being, and in his life? on the 15th of Shaaban. The night of the 15th of Shaaban, Hakima, the sister of Imam al-Hadi alayhi salam, she says, I went to the house of the Imam and he told me that tonight Waliyullah al-A'zam is going to be born. Tonight the greatest proof of Allah will be born. So she says, oh my master, who's his mother? The Imam tells her, Narjas is his mother. She says, I don't see any signs of pregnancy in Narjas. But she believes in the Imam. She goes, as she enters Narjas, she comes, because Narjas, she was initially a slave that Imam al-Hadi purchased, and then she was freed in the way of Allah. So Narjas, she came when she saw Hakima, the sister of Imam al-Hadi, she came to take off her shoes. She came to take off her shoes, and Hakima, she tells her, no. She says, why? My Sayyidati, you are my master. I want to help you. I want to take off your shoes. Hakima replies, Bal anti Sayyidati wa Sayyidatu Ahli. You are my master. You are the one who is carrying the Hujjah of Allah. You are the one who is carrying the Imam. And therefore, I shall serve you. I shall be there for you. Hakima says, within a few hours, I went to pray, and then I looked. I saw that there's no sign in birth. Then, a while later, I saw that it was time, and I went and I helped Narjas give birth to that Imam. He came to life in sujood, performing prostration to Allah, and then he recited this verse, وَنُرِيدُ أَن نَمُنَّ عَلَى الَّذِينَ اسْتُضْعِفُوا فِي الْأَرْضِ وَنَجْعَلَهُمْ أَئِمَّةً وَنَجْعَلَهُمُ الْوَارِثِينَ وَنُمَكِّنَ لَهُمْ فِي الْأَرْضِ وَنُرِيَ فِرْعَوْنَ وَهَامَانَ وَجُنُودَهُمَا مِنْهُمْ مَا كَانُوا يَحْذَرُونَ. And we shall, وَنُرِيدُ أَن نَمُنَّ, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, we shall bestow a favor upon the ones who were oppressed in the land, and we shall make them imams, and we shall make them leaders. Imam Sadiq alayhi salam, of course, this verse, it applies to Musa alayhi salam during the time of Pharaoh, and it also applies during the time of Imam al-Hujjah. Imam Sadiq alayhi salam, he says, نحن المستضعفون في الأرض. We are the ones who were oppressed in the land. We are the ones whose rights were taken from them, referring to the imams of the Ahlul Bayt. And it is true, every single imam that came, starting with Amir al-Mu'mineen, Imam al-Hassan, Imam al-Hussein, all of the imams, you see that their rights were taken away from them. They were not allowed to rule. They were not allowed to establish justice. They were not allowed to fulfill the task that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent them to do. But now, this is a promise of Allah, and no one can come in the way of the promise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now, my dear brothers and sisters, when it comes to believing in the Imam, it's very easy. Because if you believe in the prophets of Allah, you will accept the Imam. And if you accept believing in Allah, believing in the ghaib, when you read the Quran, the second chapter of the Quran, Surah Al-Baqarah, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, Alif Lam Mim, Thalika al-Kitabu la rayba fihi hudan lil-muttaqeen, Alladhina yu'minuna bil-ghaib. The ones, this book is for the ones who believe in the unseen. Now, if I don't believe in the Imam just because I don't see him, then that means there's a problem with my belief system. It's okay if we do not see the Imam, because the Imam sees us, and on a day like this, and in fact, every single day in our life, we have to renew our vows with the Imam of our time. We have to renew our oath with the Imam of our time. And we have to make sure that we are following in His path and we are ready for Him when He comes. Because the time can be any minute. Allah, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi, in a hadith, he says, Al-Mahdi minna ahl al-bayt yuslihu Allah amrahu fi layla. He says, the Mahdi is from us, ahl al-bayt. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give him permission to rise within one night. Within one night, everything can change. Who knows? It might be this night. It might be in Laylatul Qadr this year. It might be within the next few days. But the problem is, many of us, we keep doing dua, Allahumma ajjal li waliyika al-faraj. Yes, this is a promise of Allah. It will happen for sure. However, can I guarantee which side am I going to be on? Can I guarantee if I'm going to be with the Imam alayhi salam? This is why we have a responsibility, my dear brothers and sisters. When we gather in these events, we don't just gather to celebrate and then go home and act as if nothing has happened. We gather to celebrate, but also to give our oath of allegiance to the Imam, to change our lives, our course of life, and to make a pact that we will do what we can to prepare for the Imam. In a hadith from Imam Sadiq alayhi salam, he tells his companions, he tells them, Satusibukum shubha fatabqoon bila alamin yura wala imam huda. The Imam, he tells the Shias, he tells his followers, tells them there's going to be a shubha, there's going to be a crisis that you will be going through, where you will not know where is truth from falsehood. And you will remain without an imam, without a clear imam. Of course, the imam is there. And then the imam says, لا ينجو منها إلا من دعا بدعاء الغريق. The only one that will be saved is the one who performs the dua of the one who is drowning. What does that mean? That means you have to be desperate for the imam. That means you have to be sincere when you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to hasten the reappearance of the Imam. You have to be desperate. لا ينجو منها إلا من دعا بدعاء الغريق. So the companion, he asks the Imam, what is دعاء الغريق? How do we perform that dua? The Imam says, you say, يا الله يا رحمن يا رحيم يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلبي ala deenik. O Allah, O Rahman, O Rahim, O Merciful. Thabbit qalbi ala deenik. Have, ya muqallib al-qulub, the one who changes the hearts, have my heart be solid with a strong foundation in believing in your faith and in your way. And I conclude with this, and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to hasten the reappearance of the Imam of our time and make us be from the ones who follow in his footsteps and the ones who prepare for his arrival when he appears once again. Walhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen wa sallallahu ala Muhammadin wa ala alihi al-tahirin.
صلوا على محمد وآل محمد.
اللهم صل على محمد. أحسنت. And thank you very much, Sayyid Saleh, for those wonderful, very wise and educational words. Inshallah, we can all take away from that.